The Earth system is extremely unstable, and we are pushing it in a direction where the consequences are not really foreseeable.
The Pittsfield-based scientist says we're already getting a taste of climate change with severe flooding 2 years ago and increasingly milder winters, but he says that's only the beginning.
Sea level is going to be coming up about 3 to 5 feet per century, and our winters will be almost unrecognizable in terms of the Vermont with which we grew up.
He says the problem stems from greenhouse gas emissions from burning fossil fuels. The good news, he says, climate change can be mitigated, which is why the Vermont Climate Cabinet gathered in Montpelier.
What do we need to be doing more of in order to reduce our contributions to global climate change? And also, meanwhile, you know, we're seeing changes. How do we make sure we're prepared?
Lawmakers say things like reviewing floodplains and having an infrastructure that can handle extreme weather is important. At the same time, they want to move Vermont towards their goal of running on 90% renewable energy by 2050. They say that's a tall order, but well worth the fight and worth the investment that will take.
We create the future, and so it's entirely up to us to accept and understand what is going on and start the transformation, the transition of our society towards one that's much more efficient, it's powered by renewable energy, and has much greater resilience.
Now, the House Committee on Natural Resources and Energy just finished working on a bill aimed at efficiency that would help low-income Vermonters make their homes more efficient, requiring less fuel to heat. The bill hasn't made it to the floor just yet. Live in the newsroom, David Schneider, News Channel 5.